Good morning, guys. It's Saturday, 19.4. Last workout of the open. I'm ready to take it on. I'm ready for it to be over. Lot of thrusters. So I will be scaling the entire workout because I can't do chest bar pull-ups. And my shoulder is still crap. So jumping pull-ups and barbell thrusters is still going to suck. So I'm ready to do that. Getting ready, gonna head to the gym. I will see you guys there. On the way to the gym, guys, and let me tell you, it is 28 degrees. We're at the end of March. When are we gonna get some warm weather? Like, Ohio, you're killing me. I don't know how much more of this I can take. I don't know. After that workout, 19.5 kicked my ass. The funny thing is, I scaled for shoulder issues and because I can't do chest to bar pull-ups anyways. It humbles you when a 45-pound bar kicks your ass. And those jumping pull-ups, my calves were on fire when I got to, I think it was round 21. The reps of 21. I did it in 12 minutes, 29 seconds. So I wanted to do better than that. I will not be doing that over. But man, just think, like Matt Frazier, Tia Claire Toomey got it done in like half the time with more weight. So I'm home. It's Saturday. It's March Madness. So most of the day I'm just going to be watching basketball. Seeing if my Buckeyes can get through this second round. I'm surprised they even made it through the first. I hate to say that, but I can't always go with them. So they made it through. Cincinnati didn't. We only got one Ohio team left in the tourney. So we're hoping Ohio State can keep on going. I will talk to you guys later. Morning, guys. So I'm back from the gym. It's Sunday morning. just did some active recovery this time, well, today, because 19.5 wrecked me. My calves are so tight right now, so I tried to roll them out using the crossbar, using the foam roller, anything I could use. I'm probably going to use my massager that I have that I kind of got a couple months ago. It has different little adjustments that you can put on the head of it. Use that on my calves. I'll probably use that on my quads too. Hamstring, just pretty much my lower body is wrecked. And my shoulder, you've probably heard that. That popping doesn't hurt, but just that motion of the thrusters like that, that still hurts. So, probably overdid a little bit, but it was the last workout of the open, had to complete it. After I looked at my time again, I'm like, yeah, I don't know if I could have went faster, maybe, but I really didn't think a barbell thruster would kill me that much. It blows my mind. But anyway, so I kind of wanted to just bring them to you guys. I brought it up probably 3 weeks ago. I started an 8-week challenge, and it started March 3rd, and it's going to go to April 28th. I started this for myself, really, to kind of get back into my good eating habits, because February I did terrible. To me, I thought I did really bad. And I started off at 187.4. The first week I lost 6 pounds, and I got down to 181. Second week was 181. And then last week I gained 3 pounds at 183. I'm not too mad about that, because I've been having this issue probably for like the last 6 or 7 months, where I wake up in the morning and feel kind of queasy. And when I kind of describe it to people, they're like, are you pregnant? No, I'm not pregnant. Not in a relationship, not pregnant. And it happened to me about 2 years ago too, where I'd wake up, I'd eat breakfast, I'd feel fine during breakfast, and immediately afterwards, I would throw up. And it was just that for a while. And then it started getting to the point where I'd have these sharp stomach pains. So when I ran these tests at the doctors, I even had to go to the emergency room once because the pain was really, really bad. And they think, you know, maybe it's your gallbladder. I'm like, no, my gallbladder had been out for like 8 or 9 years. So it's not the gallbladder. Appendix is fine. They just couldn't figure it out. I did these tests, nothing. So it really drove me crazy. And then it just went away. It just completely went away for like a year. Until towards the end of last year, it came back. And I'd wake up in the morning and just, again, because I live in an apartment, just the smell of food would make me kind of nauseous. That would go away. And then I maybe could eat breakfast. And then after breakfast, it's the queasy feeling. Want to feel like I'm going to throw up. Thing is, I'm not actually throwing up. I kind of dry heave, which, sorry, this is probably disgusting. No one wants to hear that. But anyways, it would be where I would get really sick. And then a couple hours would go away. But I wouldn't really have an appetite. And then when the appetite finally would come, I would overeat. So that's what happened, I know, last week. When I look back at what I ate, I was just overeating. So I thought maybe it's something to do with, like, you know, the stomach bacteria. And I got some probiotic yogurt, which I really didn't need to get that. I could just probably get regular Greek yogurt, which I'll do once I eat all that up. But I've only been on it for 3 days. It feels okay. I haven't felt that nauseous feeling at all throughout the day. But I'm going to give it some time to see if it actually goes away. But it's the strangest thing. But I didn't want that setback to deter me from still continuing to eat better. I guess if I do feel sick again and I don't have an appetite, and when my appetite does come back, just eat your regular food. There's no reason why I need to think I need to make up for those calories, because I don't. Eat your regular meal. If it's lunch that you feel okay to eat, eat that. If it's not until dinner, eat dinner. Don't try to add additional calories on there. So I'm not going to do that. So this week, back to kind of the regular diet. Last weekend was not the greatest. It was St. Patrick's Day, which is one of my favorite days. It was on a Sunday, and Monday was pretty much of a hangover. But I do like to enjoy myself at times. So, you know, you work hard, you should be able to play hard too. This week, we're back at it. I still got 5 weeks left. The goal is to get down to around 175. And again, that will be really good because it'll go into the start of my marathon training. So I want to do 5 or 6 months of marathon training. And that's going to be really hard because in that span of time, I'll be traveling for work twice, end of April and in June. I also have my sister's bachelorette party, 2 bridal showers that she has, and her wedding. And then I have another wedding at the beginning of September. So the goal is by marathon time, I'm hoping to be between 165 and 170. To me, it's just how much better would it be running if you are lighter? Your joints are going to feel better. So for me, that's the goal. It's trying to knock off the pounds so it won't be so hard when I'm running. So that's pretty much it, guys. I am, again, March Madness, so it's another day of full on watching basketball. Try to throw in some golf there, but it's hard flipping back and forth through, you know, each channel. But I'm excited Ohio State plays. They play Houston. Look at my brackets. I have 6 brackets this year. I went overboard way too much. But it's fun. It's fun just trying to keep up with them. So I am going to end this here because I feel like I'm kind of rambling on now. But hope you liked the video. Hit that like button and subscribe. And I will talk to you guys later.